Whoa, I did not expect this 30-second video to get 21 million views. Credit would be nice, but I still appreciate y'all, even the pirates. I see there are a bunch of questions, so let's get into it. The trike has two 1800-watt brushless motors in the back with a split rear axle, so no need for PVC sleeves, it turns just fine. It is powered by 6 DeWalt batteries. I use the 9 amp hour packs. It can go about 10 miles on a full charge, or about 30 minutes before I notice a drop in power. The motors and controllers are rated at 48 volts, but they can handle overvolting much better than the brushed motors. I recently switched to this 10 gauge silicon wire, and it totally makes a difference. The high strand count has a super low impedance, combined with the flexible rubber coating, means no more hot wires. I also use these 45 amp Anderson power pole connectors, so no more burnt terminals. I designed the back end before I got a welder, so it has a bunch of bolts keeping it together. The no weld method works great, just be sure to use stainless steel hardware. I started building the racetrack in 2016, and my only regret is I wish I would have made it sooner. If you're thinking about doing something similar,
just do it! Make your dreams come true!
The track goes around my house, front and backyard, and through the garage. It is about an eighth of a mile long, and it can even be seen on Google Earth. But wait, there is more. I put 7 beam sensors around the track and wired them into a USB encoder to keep time. There are 3 speed traps and 3 loops, inside, outside, and the backyard. It is perfect for racing against the clock and way more accurate than a human with a stopwatch. Lastly, I am married. My wife is usually behind the camera, but she rides sometimes too. I own my house, I do not rent, and I do not live in an HOA. I'm friends with all my neighbors, and some of them ride the track as well. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll try to answer them. Thanks for watching.